At this point of commencement program, the Milwaukee School of Engineering has the great pleasure and privilege of conferring its highest testimonial on two individuals whose personal and professional lives and careers have been defined by extraordinary and creative achievements in the areas of engineering, management, and steadfast loyalty to the support of the Milwaukee School of Engineering. Your program contains information on the careers and accomplishments of these candidates, which have been duly considered by the MSOE community on honorary degrees. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention is directed to the on-stage screens for a brief video presentation.
MSOE Corporation member Mike Erwin graduated from MSOE with a degree in management systems. His career includes 25 years at Milwaukee's Harnischweger Industries, where his assignments were focused on operations, product development, and global expansion. He was named president of the P&H Material Handling Division in 1996. Today, he enthusiastically serves as the CEO of Tailored Label Products in Menominee Falls. Tailored Label is an innovative, world-class manufacturer and designer of product identification tags, labels, adhesive components, and crowd control products. The company's unique work cell design features a series of profit centers, customized to solve a problem for customers. Tailored Label has been recognized twice as Wisconsin Manufacturer of the Year, and four times as one of the top 100 best workplaces in Milwaukee. Mr. Erwin holds six patents and has twice received the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. He provides leadership to several business and community service organizations, including the United Way of Waukesha County, Community Memorial Hospital Foundation, the Muscular Dystrophy Association, and MSOE. In 2009, Tailored Label was recognized by the National Association of Manufacturers for excellence in community service. Mr. Erwin is a car and motorcycle enthusiast and enjoys hunting and fishing. He and his wife Nancy have been married for 37 years, with two grown daughters and two granddaughters. For his exemplary business leadership and dedication to education and community service, today the MSOE community joins in saluting Mike Erwin.
Regent Dr. Woody Atkins and Dr. Steve Bialik, please escort to the podium Michael S. Erwin. Regent Chairman Dr. Alan Root, ladies and gentlemen, on the recommendations of the Committee on Honorary Degrees, Michael S. Erwin is presented to you as a candidate for the honorary degree of Doctorate of Engineering.
President Beetz, in recognition of his extraordinary dedication, application, and advancement in engineering, in recognition of his expertise in manufacturing firms, has acknowledged contributor to the boards of engineering intensive manufacturing businesses and nonprofit organizations, and finally, in gratitude for the most generous support for the educational mission and enterprise of the Milwaukee School of Engineering, it is my pleasure to present Michael S. Erwin to you as candidate for the degree of Doctor of Engineering honoris causa.
By reason of the testimony contained in the citations and recommendations we have just heard, and with the authority invested in my office by the Board of Regents under charter granted to the Milwaukee School of Engineering by the State of Wisconsin, I hereby confer on you Michael S. Erwin, as presented by Vice President Berry and Chairman Dr. Alan Rood, the degree Doctor of Engineering Honoris Causa, together with all the honors, rights, and privileges. Congratulations on this auspicious occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Michael Erwin.
Well, to begin with, imagine there's an entrepreneur embedded in each of you. Can you imagine traveling the world, meeting, befriending engineers, inventors, business dreamers? I know I can. Imagine a world where all of you are there to design, solve, test, cure, innovate, fail, learn from those failures and start over, and then turn your idea into a solution and that clever solution into a new or improved business. Imagine a lifetime use of the theory and practices that you've absorbed earning your degree. 40 years ago, after graduation the first time, I launched into imagining a new plant design to help grow a new business venture, and then troubleshooting advanced technology around the globe, along with creating complex machinery solutions. And then adding a second degree here 20 years ago provided entrepreneurial skills into merger and acquisition work, organizational development, leadership, commercializing inventions, rapid change management, and global business growth. My first small invention 30 years ago is still a $2 million product today, providing a safer industrial workplace in thousands of locations around the world. A recent invention has resulted in a technologically very clever business unit at Tailored Label, which has generated over $5 million in revenue, along with new careers for the people that get to an opportunity to craft that special product. Add five more inventions over the past 5 years, and now you've built a platform for a special business and fuel for more entrepreneurial opportunities to imagine. The greatest lesson I've learned is to imagine. I imagined a patent or two for something clever someday and craft a business from it. Check. I imagine leading a technology-based business or two or three. Check again. I imagine traveling the world many times over, learning and absorbing what other entrepreneurs imagined along their way. I imagined a great family of my own. A small sample is up on the top row there, with another one ready to join us any day now, and for a second, I thought any minute now. The fact of the matter is, this graduating class will collectively contribute $80 million a year to a normal business. The serious risk takers in this hall today, likely about 10% of you, will create your own business with a combined annual revenue of at least $200 million a year. That's a dream number for an entrepreneur. Imagine that. And 1% of you will have the opportunity to be the power behind the next revolutionary biomedical device, or join the robotic and 3D production evolution, or build your own engineering app that's part of the Internet of Everything. I never imagined sitting in the jump seat of an Airbus, landing it in Melbourne, Australia, or teaching for 15 years at MSOE, or building new plants from scratch in England, Saudi Arabia, Singapore, and Malaysia. I never imagined standing on the top of the Kennedy Space Center at the shuttle, looking down on it, not up at it, or participating in the building of a modern steel mill in the jungles of Thailand, or building equipment to service and place the missiles and Trident submarines. I never imagined manufacturing the smallest and most secure DNA test label for cryogenic chambers used around the world, or making security wristbands for American Idol. Standing 300 feet above the ocean floor on the largest container crane in the world, I never imagined building a powerful military winch tested right here at MSOE. And I never imagined participating in the privatization of a manufacturing company in Poland, helping them with their challenges of imagining the free enterprise system. An entrepreneur's imagination is not much different than anyone else's. We're just wired to go beyond a solution and build a sustainable business around our ideas and creations, a business that others will join us in imagining. That's the true entrepreneurial outcome. Imagine if I was risk averse, then all I'd have would be interesting ideas bottled up inside. Like many of us have, this journey of imagining and creating a business around your dream is its own reward. Reward yourselves by constantly imagining. Never stop taking risk or learning and sharing knowledge. Never stop giving back or paying it forward or accepting help from friends, family, peers, or mentors. The process of using your imagination is a very, very special strength. My personal challenge to each and every one of you is go imagine. Thanks to the leadership of MSOE for this unimaginable honor.